As we discussed about the types of mirrors, those types of mirrors, player mirror, already discussed in the previous class. Today's class we are discussing about the spherical mirror. Spherical mirror means a spherical mirror is one of the type of the mirror which has the shape of a twice cut out of the spherical surface or the reflecting surface which is part of the sphere is called as a spherical mirror. What is the reflecting surface which is part of the sphere, that is called as a spherical mirror. For example, consider a rubber ball and cut this rubber ball into two parts. So what do you get when you cut the rubber ball into two parts? We are getting two parts, each part having two surfaces. One is the inner surface and another one is the outer surface. For example, consider this is the rubber ball. When we cut this rubber ball into two parts, we are getting like this. Okay, so each of the part having the two surfaces, that is the outer surface and this is the inner surface. Here this is the outer surface, here this is the inner surface. Each part having the two surfaces, one is the inner surface and another one is the outer surface. So like in this manner, the spherical mirrors are parts of the two glass spheres. The spherical mirrors are part of the glass spheres. Consider a glass sphere. Okay, for example, consider this is a glass sphere. Okay, when we cut the glass sphere into two parts, we are getting the two parts like this. Okay, so this is also having two surfaces. One of the surface is outer surface and another surface is inner surface. Okay, what do you get when we cut the glass sphere into two parts? Then we are getting each of the two parts has two types of the surfaces. So like as a ball, one is the outer surface and another one is the inner surface. So these spherical mirrors are classified into two types. How many types of spherical mirrors are there? Two types of spherical mirrors are there, in that the first one is the concave mirror and the second one is the convex mirror. Concave mirror and second one is the convex mirror. There are two types of mirrors, spherical mirrors, convex mirror and concave mirror. Now let us see the first one, concave mirror. So the concave mirror is nothing but, the concave mirror is a mirror whose reflecting surface is curved inwards. So concave mirror is a mirror whose reflecting surface is curved inwards. That means the reflecting part is the inner part of the sphere. For example, consider this figure. Okay. here. This surface, that is nothing but outer surface, is coated with either silver or aluminium. Outer surface is coated with either silver or aluminium, and this is the surface of reflecting part. Reflecting part. Okay, so this is the concave mirror here. So in this concave mirror, whose reflecting surface is curved inwards, that means the reflecting part is inner surface. So those such type of mirrors are called as a concave mirror. And next one is the convex mirror. Convex mirror. So convex mirror means, a convex mirror is a spherical mirror whose reflecting surface is curved outwards. Okay, whose reflecting surface is curved outwards is called as a convex mirror. Now consider this figure. Okay, here the inner surface is coated with either silver or aluminium. The inner surface is coated with silver or aluminium, and here the outer surface is the reflecting part. Here this is the reflecting part. Reflecting part of the mirror. Okay, so such type of mirrors are called as a convex mirror. So what is the difference between the convex mirror and concave mirror? In case of convex mirror, the light reflects outerwards of the sphere. Okay, in case of concave mirror, the light reflects innerwards of the sphere. Okay, so that is the difference between the concave mirror and convex mirror. And next one, important parameters of the spherical mirrors. In that, the first important parameter is center of curvature. Center of curvature. Now consider the two spheres. Consider two spheres. Here the first sphere reflects the convex lens. Why? Because the inner surface is coated with the metals, that is nothing but either silver or aluminium. And the second sphere is the concave mirror. Why? Because here the outer surface is coated with the aluminium or silver. Okay, here and here the outer surface is the reflecting part. And in this sphere, the inner surface is the reflecting part. So this is the convex mirror and this is the concave mirror. Okay. And the two spheres having the centers C1 and C2. That means here the C1 be the center of the sphere S1 and the C2 be the center of the sphere, second sphere. The C1 be the center of the first sphere and C2 be the center of the second sphere. That means here the C1 be the center of the convex mirror and C2 be the center of the concave mirror. Here the C1 and C2 are called as the center of curvatures of the mirrors. The C1 be the center of the convex, center of curvature of the convex mirror, and the C2 be the center of curvature of the concave mirror. Okay, here the C1 be the center of the sphere 1 and C2 be the center of the sphere 2. The sphere forms the convex lens, the sphere 2, the second sphere forms the concave lens. The first sphere forms the convex lens and the second sphere forms the concave lens. So the C1 be the center of curvature of the convex lens and C2 be the center of curvature of concave lens. And next one is the radius of curvature. Radius of curvature. So radius of curvature means each and every sphere has radius. So let R1 be the radius of the curvature of the radius of sphere 1 and R2 be the radius of the sphere 2. Okay. So the first sphere forms convex lens, sorry, convex mirror, and the second sphere forms concave mirror. So here the R1 be the radius of curvature of the convex mirror and R2 be the radius of curvature of concave mirror. Okay, here the R1 be the radius of the sphere 1 and R2 be the radius of the sphere 2. The sphere 1 forms the convex mirror and the sphere 2 forms the concave mirror. So the R1 be the radius of curvature of the convex mirror and R2 be the radius of curvature of the concave mirror. And next one is the pole. Pole. The center of the mirror surface is called its pole. The center of the mirror surface is called as a pole. Here, so this is the center of the mirror. So here, this is the P be the center of the mirror of the concave, convex mirror. And in this case, P2 be the center of the mirror of concave mirror. Here P1 be the center of the convex mirror and P2 be the center of the concave mirror. So the P1 and P2 are the poles of the convex mirror and concave mirror respectively. Here the P1 be the pole of the convex mirror and P2 be the pole of the concave mirror. Okay, and next one is the principal axis. Principal axis. Principal axis means the line passes through the pole and the center of the curvature. Passes through the center of the curvature of the mirror is called as a principal axis. The line which is passes through the pole and the center of the curvature of the mirror is called principal axis. Here the C1 be the center of the curvature of sphere 1 and P1 be the center of the curvature of the sphere 1. Sorry, P1 be the pole of the mirror formed by the spear one. Okay, here the spear one forms the convex mirror. So here the C1 and P1 are the center of the curvature of the convex mirror, and P1 be the pole of the convex mirror. The line which is passes through the center of the curvature of the convex mirror and pole of the convex mirror is called as a principal axis of the convex mirror. Here the line which is passes through the center of the curvature of the convex mirror and the center of pole of the convex mirror. So this line is called as a principal axis. Principal axis of this convex mirror. Okay, and in this case here the C2 be the center of curvature of the convex mirror, concave mirror, and P2 be the pole of the concave mirror. The line which is passes through the C2 and P2, that is nothing but both the center of curvature and pole. The line which is passes through the center of curvature and pole. So this line is called as a principal axis of concave mirror. The line which is passes through the center of curvature of the convex mirror and pole of the concave mirror. Sorry, center of curvature of the concave mirror and pole of the concave mirror. So that line is called as a principal axis of concave mirror. Okay, here this is the principal axis of the convex mirror. Why? Because this sphere forms a concave mirror. Here this is the principal axis of concave mirror. Why? Because here this sphere forms the concave mirror. And next one is the principal focus. Principal focus means when the light ray incident on the mirror, and that light ray, the incident light ray which is parallel to the principal axis. Here this is the principal axis. When we incident the light ray in this manner, here this incident ray is parallel to the principal axis. Okay, so then the light ray reflects back in this manner. So this is the reflected ray. So this reflected ray intersects the principal axis at particular point. So that point is called as a principal focus. So that intersect point, the intersect point of reflected ray and the principal axis is called as a principal focus. When we incident the incident ray which is parallel to the principal axis. Here this is the principal focus of convex mirror. So in this case, when we incident the light ray in this manner, the light ray reflects in this manner. Here this is the intersect point. Here this is the principal focus of concave mirror. Okay, and next one is the focal length. Focal length is nothing but the distance between the pole and the principal focus. Here this is the pole and this is the principal focus. Here the distance between the pole and the principal focus is called as a focal length. Here the distance between these two, the distance between the this point and this point is called as a focal length. Here this is the focal length of the convex mirror. Here this is the focal length of the concave mirror. So these are the important parameters of the spherical mirrors. So how many types of spherical mirrors are there? Two types of spherical mirrors are there: concave mirror and convex mirror. So concave mirror means The reflected path is inner surface of the sphere. In case of convex mirror, the reflected path, the light reflects on the outer surface of the sphere. Okay, so and the important parameters of the spherical mirror is center of curvature, radius of curvature, pole and principal axis, principal focus and focal length. Okay, these are the six important parameters of spherical mirror. So in that, the first one is the center of curvature. The center of spherical curvature means the center of the sphere which is formed the convex mirror which is formed by the sphere. Here the C1 and C2 be the center of curvatures of the sphere 1 and sphere 2. Okay, and the sphere 1 forms the convex lens and the sphere 2 forms the concave mirror. The sphere 1 forms the convex mirror and the sphere 2 forms the concave mirror. Here the C1 be the center of curvature of the convex mirror and C2 be the center of curvature of concave mirror. And R1 and R2 be the radius of curvatures of the sphere 1 and sphere 2. That is nothing but here R1 be the radius of curvature of convex mirror and R2 be the radius of curvature of concave mirror. And pole is nothing but the center of the mirror. Here the P1 be the pole of the convex mirror and P2 be the pole of the concave mirror. And principal axis is nothing but the line which is passes through the center of curvature and the pole. Here this is the line passes through the center of curvature and pole. So this is the principal axis of convex lens in this case. So this is line passes through the center of curvature of C2 and P2. So this is the line, this is the principal axis of convex concave mirror. And principal focus means when the light ray incidents on the concave mirror or convex mirror which is parallel to the incident ray, which is parallel to the principal axis. So then the light ray reflects back, so the reflected ray intersects the principal axis, so the intersect point is called as a principal focus. And focal length is nothing but the distance between two points, that is nothing but pole and focal length, principal focus. So the distance between the pole and principal focus is called as a focal length. So these are the six important parameters of spherical mirror. Thank you.